So I'm not dead, and as far as I know, I'm not dying. But I am pissed, and I wanted to make this video because I think it's overdue, and I have some confessions to make. So here it is. So as I mentioned, I am pissed, and I'm pissed because honestly, I think I can do better. And that's why I must kill the old version of myself and create a new one. And I talk about this in my program, Surplus Fund Mastery. And yes, I did buy surplusfund.com, as you can see from the intro. The website's not built yet, but I've got some special stuff coming your way very, very soon that I'll be sharing with you. And I'll talk more about that in a second because it does relate to this topic. But I'm pissed because I don't think I've been getting the absolute best out of myself with my business, with the people around me. And so for that, I want to apologize, first of all. But I also want to make this point very, very clear. There's a lot of people that'll tell you, oh, you know what, take it easy in life. Life is about balance. And all of that is great for some people. But for me, life is about performance. Life is about being the best that I can absolutely be at my craft. And with that being said, when I feel like I'm not living up to that potential, I don't feel good about myself. And I think that's okay. I don't think that you should feel good about yourself if you're not living up to your potential. If you right now, if you have the capability, which by the way, I think everyone does, of making $1 million a year, $2 million a year, and you're making $100,000, that's great. For some people, it'd be like, oh my God, I want to make six figures. Dude, you could make seven. Like, you should be living up to your potential. And I'm not gonna sit here and judge myself based on, or judge my level of success based on what other people perceive as successful. Meaning that I could sit here and be like, oh, you know what, I'm 21, I'm making X amount of money, which at any age anybody would be happy to make. But even at 21, that's amazing. You know, I've got an amazing company that we're working on building. You know, I've got all these great things going for me, and I'm not happy because guess what? I'm not living up to my potential because I know yes, I'm doing this, but I can do way more. And I'm telling you right now is that I guarantee in somewhere in your life right now, there you could be doing more. You might be already successful, right? Successful in most people's eyes, but you could be doing more. And maybe the current version of yourself is not the right person to achieve those goals. So what do I mean by this? I mean this very, very simply. In life, many people, and by the way, I'm not a life coach, so I'm not gonna sit here and try to act like I know a bunch of stuff. I just know what works for me, and if it works for you, awesome. If it doesn't, then ignore everything I'm saying. Anyways, I know that for me, instead of trying to achieve a goal that seems super difficult, I just want to become the person that can achieve that goal easily. So I'll give you an example of this. Mark Cuban's a billionaire, right? So if Mark Cuban in 2019 only made $1 million, he would have like the worst year of his life. He'd be like, oh my God, he's like, I'm going bankrupt. Like everything would go downhill very, very fast for him, right? And that's because Mark Cuban's up here. He's playing at a much higher or much closer position to his full potential. But for us, like if we make, oh my gosh, if I made $10 million this year, like that'd be game changing. But for Mark Cuban, it'd be like, oh my God, I didn't make anything this year, right? And so my point is, instead of trying to be the guy that barely scrapes by and gets to 10 million, if that, I want to be like, Mark Cuban's a bad example, but I want to be like at that potential, playing at that potential where $10 million, if I made that, that'd be a bad year, right? And that's what I'm trying to say to you guys is stop trying to achieve your goals with the crappy habits and disciplines that you have currently and rebuild yourself, change yourself into the person that easily accomplishes those goals. So what exactly am I not happy about? And that is what we're gonna get into the meat and potatoes of this video. You see, I am disgusted by the info product business. Now let me clarify before I continue here. I'm not talking about my business. Obviously, I wouldn't be selling crap that I didn't think was good. I'm just disgusted with not even necessarily our competitors, but just this whole space of info businesses. Because, you know, part of my job is to see what a lot of other people that are in this kind of industry are doing, that are selling courses and all that, and see what they're doing. And honestly, it is so disgusting the things these people are doing to sell programs. I mean, it literally kind of makes me throw up a little bit in my mouth. In fact, the other day I was on Instagram and I'm scrolling through the stories and a story ad pops up. And I don't, I'm not, I kind of remember what this guy's username is, but I'm not gonna put him on blast. But the ad was basically this kid with like this montage of him with like some hot chicks, and he's like, okay, like doing a backflip into like a pool or something. And then he's like, hey, like I dropped out of school because I decided I was gonna make money online. swipe up and I'll show you how. It's like, dude, what does any of this have to do with you making money online, number one? Number two is, that's not how business works, okay? Like, when I decided that I was done with school, I wasn't like, all right, I'm done with school and I'm gonna go make money. I was like, no, I was already making a lot of money. And I was like, you know what? I think it just makes more sense to put my time over here. It was never like this big thing. I didn't have to go around and be like, hey guys, I'm not going to school because I decided to drop out and make money. Like, that's not what I was doing. That's stupid, okay? That's ridiculously stupid. Anyway, back onto my rant about info businesses in general. Somehow people have correlated fame with financial and business success. And I don't understand this because I'll give you a really good example here. So if we look up on Google, Drake, okay? Drake, everybody watching this video has probably heard of Drake or knows about Drake. If you don't know who Drake is, he's the most commercially successful rapper probably ever. With the exception of like Jay-Z and people who've like turned it into like its own business. But as far as just selling records and stuff, he's probably number one, if not top three. And he's definitely the most successful of the last 10 years. You can't argue that. Anyways, he's worth $150 million, okay? That's his net worth. I think we can all agree he's very, very, very successful. Again, he kind of came off in 2009, so it took about a 10-year career to go from zero to $150 million, give or take a little bit, okay? All that sounds great and well. I think everybody would say, hey, you know what? Dude, power to him. He's very successful. That's awesome. If you tried to learn business from Drake and you had the opportunity to learn it from this guy, you would be very, very, very stupid because this guy is, his name's Jeff, and he's worth $152 or $157 billion. And by the way, this sounds utterly ridiculous, but this is exactly what people do nowadays with courses, okay? So what they do is they're like, oh, this Shopify, I know this is Drake's Instagram account, but pretend like this is a Shopify guru. Oh, he's got 59 million followers. He must know more about business than this guy who's only got a million followers. Oh, okay, let's buy his course. Like, no, dude, that makes no sense, okay? Followers do not have anything to do with knowing anything about business, okay? There are people right now that are worth billions of dollars that you've literally never even heard of or seen on Instagram because they don't have an Instagram account or a YouTube account or a LinkedIn account or a Facebook account. Like, they just don't exist, okay? At least in social media, right? But they're worth billions of dollars. But then there's all these people that, like, they post videos of them with a Porsche and they're like, I know everything about business. Swipe up and get my course. And it's just utterly ridiculous, okay? And so this very much frustrates me because now that I'm on the other side of this business and not as a customer, but I'm as someone that's operating one of these businesses, I just see all of this ridiculousness and it's honestly disgusting to me. And because of that, I feel that it is my not only financial responsibility, because obviously I'm gonna benefit from that, but it's honestly my moral obligation to take as many people that would buy those courses and give them something much better, which surplusfund.com, Surplus of Mastery, but get them away from that. And that's why I'm making this video, and that's why I'm very upset with myself, because I don't think that I've been as disciplined as I need to be. I don't think that I, you know, like, honestly, the last couple days, I've just had, like, this headache, because I've fucking been looking at this all day, and it's like, the stuff that you see on this is just so stupid. Like, people giving business advice on Instagram about when you should buy a Lamborghini, and, like, I don't know, okay? I don't know. But the point I'm trying to make is I need to be better. I need to be more disciplined because there's less people need to be victimized by these ridiculous scams on the internet. Again, I'm not calling anybody out in particular, but if you've been around this game for a while, you've definitely seen some of these before, okay? So with that being said, guys, hopefully this makes sense. I'm gonna be more disciplined. Hopefully you'll be more disciplined. I'm gonna link down below my new SOP, or I should say I'm renewing my SOP, which is my daily schedule of what time I wake up and all that, just so you guys can see what my new discipline plan is. With that being said, guys, I'll see you later. Real quick, guys, this is the what you can get in the link down below. It's just my daily schedule and my operating procedures and all that. So if you wanna check that out, click it down below, and I'll see you there.